Okay, I'm doing my dip nails here, and I'm prepping by buffing the shine off of my nails. I've already pushed back my cuticles and used a cuticle remover. Now I'm sanitizing with a rubbing alcohol and a gauze wipe using Prep by Red Carpet. It is a drying solution for nails. This time I'm choosing to use a peelable base coat on part of my nail, making sure it's only in the middle and doesn't go to the edge either at the top or the sides. And this helps with removal and doesn't damage my nails as much. The color I'm using is Reflect by Revel Nail. It's kind of end up being a navy blue with gold flecks. Starting with the Revel Nail Pro Base, making sure to wipe the sides. I'm going in with the base, and then I take a quarter teaspoon little scoop thing to scoop the powder over my nails, and this helps to make it easier when I'm filing. And then I do kind of go in for a second dip after I put that initial coat on. You want to work quickly when you're doing this because the Pro Base can dry pretty quickly, so you want to make sure you get dipped or poured over before it dries. And then I always make sure that there's nothing on my skin before I dip as well. And I take a brush and brush off the nails after waiting about a minute or so. And then I go in and take actually a dry toothbrush to help get some excess off there too. So for the second coat, I want to make sure to wipe off my brush in between nails and before I put it back in the bottle, because it can harden the brush head, making it difficult to use. I typically like to use probably usually three coats. And then if I am putting on a color that has glitter, I always do a clear dip powder before I file it. And this helps to make sure it's not filing away any of the glitter. I always do one hand first. I do it all, do all the steps up until the activator, and then I'll do my other hand, so then they'll all be at the same place. But I only do one hand at a time just to help with making sure it's not drying before I can get it dipped. Here I'm going in with the clear dip powder, and this is, like I said, if I'm using any sort of powder that has a glitter in it, I'll do clear on top. That way when I file, I don't file away the glitter and it doesn't get chunky. With the clear coat, I'm not using the pour over method because it's pretty finely milled. Next up, I'm using the activator. I'll do one coat on all nails, making sure I cap off the tip of the nail as well. And I do wipe off the brush in between each nail to make sure there's no powder that can make the brush hard. Do this on both hands and then let it dry for a couple minutes, and then I will go into the filing and making it smooth. So I first will take the edges and just kind of lightly smooth them out. Again, you don't want to file too much and file the color away. Then I'll take a buffing block and lightly buff off the tops. And I like to try to get closer to my cuticle, and I kind of file it and make it a little bit thinner there. That way when it grows out, it doesn't like get caught on things like my hair and stuff. And I'll just file until it feels smooth. You can see that I'll file for a little bit and then I'll feel it with my finger and make sure it's smooth. And then once it's smooth, I'll stop. Now, after buffing and smoothing the surface, just rinse your hands with water only and then dry them. And then you put your second coat of activator on, again, making sure you're capping the ends. And you let this dry and then you'll be ready to finish. So 1 minute, and then you'll wipe off each finger with a paper towel and then go into your finish gel. Your finish gel first coat should be quick, you know, 2 to 3 brush strokes. Don't worry about getting, you know, don't get too close to the cuticle. Don't worry about capping off the ends. Then you'll want to after about a minute, go into your second coat, and this one you can take more slow, you know, more slow and detailed, and then that's where you're going to cap off the ends. But you don't want to overbrush because it can have a negative effect on the shine of the nails. So that's something I learned in this process. So I always make sure I moisturize after doing the nails because they can get pretty dried out. And then this should last me for a couple weeks. Bye. Here you'll get to see them shortly. They'll be nice and shiny, ready to go.